Hello, my people, and welcome to DarthMod for Empire Total War. We're going to be doing a little campaign today. We're going to be playing as the Dutch in DarthMod. Now, DarthMod is often given credit for being the best mod for Empire Total War. I use a plethora of all sorts of different overhaul mods, and DarthMod is just one of the many that I enjoy. And it is pretty good. It adds a lot to the game, makes it significantly better than the vanilla base game, so I enjoy using DarthMod. We're gonna go ahead and play on normal, because it's stupidly hard if you go too hard or very hard. The AI in these games, they receive a number of little cheats, which are intended to make the game more difficult. Sometimes it's just pure stupid. Yeah, the mortars in this, they add mortars as garrison troops. They can wipe out your entire army. And then if you use the mortars, they hardly hit anything at all. So you want to try and avoid silliness like that. The short campaign is what we're doing here. We have to capture and hold 15 regions by the end of 1750, including Flanders, New Andalusia, French Guiana, Karnataka, the Netherlands, New York, Curacao, Ceylon, and Dutch Guiana. And in our little description here, it says, the United Provinces are a Protestant stronghold in northwestern Europe, a place where science, trade, and freedom of thought have flourished since the Spanish were driven out in the last century. Huzzah. Having tamed their land and held back the sea, the Dutch have also embraced the sea and become the foremost naval power in the world. A mere generation ago, the Dutch navy sailed into the Thames and burned the English fleet at anchor. I don't think the English were too happy about that, no. This kind of bravado and expertise is not quickly forgotten. We're starting in the year 1700, and we're going to go ahead and dump ourselves into Europe. And look, we got a Dutch loading screen. There's some Dutch ships in there.
Your first priority should be to defend your home region against the Catholic Spanish.
Saucy.
We're seeking to destroy Protestantism and restore superstition and fear to the land.
Nasty.
Following that, capturing Flanders would not only expel the Spanish from northern Europe, it would also unite all Netherlanders under a single banner.
Absolutely.
It's important to make and maintain alliances with other Protestant nations.
Britain?
You're already allied to Britain by virtue of William of Orange's position on the throne of England.
Yay.
And the military might of Prussia could make them an important ally.
Yeah, they're scary.
You should also try to expand your colonial possessions in the Caribbean Sea.
Indeed.
Trade is an essential part of Dutch culture. So keep sending Indiaman merchant ships to the trade theatres in the South Atlantic, East Indies, off the coast of Africa, and your colonies in the Caribbean and Ceylon. Maintain a navy to patrol your sea trade routes and protect them from attack.
Well, ain't that spiffy. Goodbye, funny lady. We get the Gregorian calendar, ain't that nice? Many Protestant nations in Europe, with the notable exception of Great Britain, have grudgingly adopted the reforms to the Julian calendar, first proposed in the Papal Bull of 1582 by Pope Gregory XIII. The new calendar seeks to correct the gradual drifting forward of the seasons and the Feast of Easter under the old Julian calendar, which was 11 days longer than its civil equivalent. The Gregorian reforms removed the extra days and inserted a leap year, that's where that's from. An extra day every 4 years to further correct the previous drift. Yeah. Leap year always throws everyone off. Isn't it terrible if you have a birthday on the day of the leap year? You only have an actual birthday. What if 4 years? We're going to go ahead and lower the taxes for everyone. Not just because I like being particularly nice, but I like provincial growth. Yes. I like growing my towns, and it also does help build the economy over time as well. Might seem like you're struggling a little bit at first, but it's worth it. We got a gentleman here, and put him into Utrecht, and he's going to start researching canister shot, make our cannons a little more effective on the battlefield, a bit more useful. Let's go ahead and put this navy in here for now. Might need them against the Spanish. Got this army. Plop it into Amsterdam. Got a lot of pikemen and militia. We're definitely going to have to build up that army. because I'm going to assume we're going to need it to attack Brussels here. The Spanish have that little bit of stuff. And we don't want them to have that stuff, because it's supposed to be for us. Yeah, and as Spain, you really want to get rid of that province, because it becomes quite a money pit. You're just pouring all your resources and troops into there to try and defend it. It's quite useless, actually. It doesn't even make you that much money in return. Let's try and sabotage the building. Oh, we were successful. Nice. So that should mean they shouldn't be able to recruit any troops there. We're going to go and check on America, see what we got. Oh, here we got the pirates here. Baltazar. Sounds quite terrifying, doesn't it? We're going to go ahead and raid the pirate ports in Antigua. And down in San Jose. And then we'll bring him back over here. And what we're going to do here is we're going to put this militia unit in this port. And the reason we put the militia in the port is so that the port doesn't get raided. That's pretty much it. They might cut off the trade to it, but at least the port isn't burned to the ground and can still provide us a bit of money. We've got this guy here. He's going to make the place a little more Protestant. And we've got this navy under Hendrik Gravy. It's the gravy boat. Yes. Let's send the gravy boat to the East Indies for trading. Nice little tidbit here about DarthMod is it doesn't matter what ships you put on a trade node, they all trade anyway. So you could be really nasty and just put a whole bunch of first rates just on a trade node. Because why not? Because you can. So we'll leave that guy over there. We'll actually go ahead and build up a couple fifth rates in America. And we should probably expand this navy here. And let's make a flute. Actually, should we send it? We should make another flute here because we can. We actually get endless amount of flutes. Hey, that's saucy. I like that. We're going to go ahead and build up all these cobbled roads and basic roads. Help our turn income. What else we got here? Some little buildings. Ooh, an open gem pit. Please. Another one. A gold mine. This place is going to give us a little bit of money, isn't it? I like that. I like money. There we go. That everybody? Yeah. Let's go ahead and do some recruitment before we run out of cash. Ooh, it's a hard one. Definitely want more cavalry in that, as well as a good amount of line infantry, and we'll start making some sepoys in India. Now, here we get two different types of colonial line. They are subtly better, this other unit. You can only get four of them, though. And the main difference here is their melee attack is 8 instead of the regular 6 over here, and their melee defense is 14 instead of 13. Morale is the same, though. So they're just a little bit better in combat. We'll go ahead and get those first. Okay, so we've recruited everywhere. Let us build up our towns. What can we do here? Definitely a barracks. We want to expand in India. Get that cannon foundry. Conservatorium and governor's residence. I want to try and go after Mysore in India. Because it's just quite an easy target. What do we got here? Let's do that opera house. And the House of Representatives. Why not? Next, let's go trade with some people. We're very friendly with Britain. It's quite good. Let's see, can we... Ooh. No, I don't want to give you... I don't want to give you that much money. Who else we got? The Ottomans. The Ottomans are pretty good trade. Why? Why do you want that much cash from me? I mean, it's not like I can build anything this turn anyway. Jeez. Yeah, let's trade with Spain. Right before we go to war with them. How about Austria? No. Oh, where's that? Westphalia, that's next to us. We're gonna have to kill it eventually. What? That's unacceptable. Fine. I'll pay some people. Trade. 3,000. To be allied to Prussia? Sure. What else we got here? Sweden. We definitely want to trade with Sweden. It's very satisfactory of them. Isn't that nice? Hanover's right next to us. Rejected? How dare you? What if I allow you to walk through my land? That it actually worked. All they wanted to do was walk through our land. This isn't going to be the same for this guy? Let's see, Westphalia. Oh my lord, it is. Nah. Oh boy. So we've just made them significantly happy. So let's look at our ministers. Who do we got in our government here? Who's any good? Our head isn't too fantastic. Treasury's not that fantastic either. What about this navy guy? Okay, they're both patrons. Army? No, he's definitely not army. What happens if we put this guy in navy? Not much changes. Okay. You're alright for America. Yeah, I guess you're okay. What we do want to try and do eventually is kick out the Republic and go for monarchy. That's going to be the fun part of this. So I believe we've done everything we need to do. And we're going to do something here. We're going to try and buy Brussels from Spain. Regions. Flanders. Payments. I'll offer you 3,000 for it. Ah, rejected? Well, isn't that a shame. We'll give him a go again next turn. And otherwise we're going to attack it. So, sucks to be them. Let's go ahead and end the turn. Pirates. Oh, here we go. Oh, dear. Oh. I guess we might as well fight it. 3 Zebex. 5th rate. I guess we gotta fight the first battle, don't we? What do we got here? The wow. Wow, look at that ship. Zemu. Zrip. These are funny names. The Wrecker. Yeah, pirate's gonna get wrecked. That's fun. The Wolpenberg. And Wolfswinkel. That sounds naughty. What did they get? The Marais Noir? Tomb? Well, that doesn't sound too appealing. Widowmaker? How about no? I'll turn you into a bloody widow. Dragon Dargent. Not sure that's how you say that. I'm terrible with the frog talk. But we've got Mr. Krabs! Yeah! Our navy's led by Mr. Krabs. And we're going against Federico Calles. I think he's a knockoff Spaniard or something. So we're going to go ahead, and we're going to give it a little fight. We'll see it in. Welcome to the war. And these are our saucy little boats. Ain't they pretty? Yes. It's quite an interesting flag. Look at that. Well, looks like they're going to be spawning over here. So, what we'll do is group them together, and we'll go at them from here. And we got them in line of attack. Put our sloops in the back. Flutes and our sixth rate. I want to try and capture those Zebex, because, quite frankly, they're annoying. They're incredibly annoying. Why would they give me this position? This is terrible. My boats don't want to move. How about if I ungroup you? Will you move then? They're not moving at all. What's wrong with them? Why is it doing that? They're not even extending sail whatsoever. Now are they doing something? Naval battles are incredibly annoying. I don't like naval battles. Here's the pirates. Yeah, it's a bit bigger than ours. These are piss pots. Hate them. Incredibly annoying. Let's go this way. Oh good, are we finally moving? Great. Yeah, the wind is definitely catching it now. It's pretty though. I'll give it that. Naval battles are quite pretty. There's our fleet. Okay. Turn yourselves a bit more. That's an interesting looking position you've got yourselves in there. How about you form more of a line like that then, eh? Make them come after us this way. You can go ahead and put full sail out. You know, people. Don't gotta worry about it. Okay, let's speed it up a bit. These naval battles can be quite slow. We're just really trying to reposition ourselves here. What are you doing? Oh, there we go. The opening bits of the fight. What we want to do is try and get our flutes to board their Zebex. And I say we want them to board because they are particularly better. The problem is they're across our bow, and it doesn't help with this stupid wind. Oh, there's nice shots. Yeah. Let's get him in here and do some chain shot. Pull in a bit closer across him. We can ungroup our ships. We want our regular boats to go after his admiral's ship. Let's start slipping things here. Well, our flutes prepare for that. And we'll give him some chain shot. Nice. Go after their sails. Try and do the same with the sloop here. Set him to the same thing. Gee. These are certainly taking their sweet time. Oof. That's not so nice. As long as we get onto his Zebex, we'll be alright. You're not hitting too much there. Ooh. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm gonna switch you to Grape Shot. Yeah, it's not going too well, is it? Let's get those over there. I'm supposed to be going after you, after you, after you. Oh dear. Hull damage. Yeah, I'm quite sure. Get right in there. We want you to... Yeah, that's not nice. We want you to board him. Have these come around here. There we go. He's getting in there. Switch you to Grape Shot. Have you do the same. Get him to attach himself. You're having severe difficulty over here. Going after that fifth raid. And you're supposed to be going after him. Oh wow. That definitely knocked out quite a few A's. Looks like he's coming around to board him. You still need to get closer in on him. I'd say go ahead and just do round shot again. Go after him with round shot. There we go. Now we've got them more closer. Wow, that was nice. Yeah, if you can get in close with them and really rake their deck with Grape Shot. The enemy doesn't want to have it. Concerned casualties. I'm quite sure they are. Just keep on hammering them. They're wavering away. Bring it back around. Looks like you're finally getting into boarding. That knocks off quite a lot of their deck. Yeah. We want to capture these guys. That's the whole goal of this. Right, let's get you on Grape Shot too. Yeah. That upsets them. Now if we just stay in close with them. Come around here, we'll sail it. How you people doing? You're still routing. We want to capture you, though. Make you surrender. Yeah, let's keep in line with him. Oh yeah, he got a good smack. And that Grape Shot of mine there. He's not doing too happy. He's say this is going a lot better than a number of my naval battles. Terrible about the wind, though. Quite sucky about that. It's really against us. Let's bring you in closer. Let's bring you around here, too. Yeah. Oh, he surrendered. Oh, brilliant. Nice. Okay. You can detach yourself from boarding and run around here. Yeah, he's done. He surrendered too. Brilliant. Bring yourselves around. I want you to come over here and attack them. You're still having a little trouble capturing him, by the looks of it. This sloop was just like, hey, I want to play. And then, let's just rake his deck. Try and get some chain shot off on him. Two do grape, one do chain. Let's see how that works. Surrender. After him. I want to see if we can demast him. Yeah, taking quite a bit of hull damage here. Well, we need you more in the fight. So if you could please come over this way, that'd be fantastic. Let's see. How are you doing? Need you guys around to get him from the side. To give him a couple more smackings there. Let's try and bring you back around, cut him from the front. We're just chasing after this guy. Come on. Our sixth rate has the best chance of making this guy a little upset. Let's just stop him right in front, eh? Let's just anchor that there. And let's do this. Because, see, he can't go too far now. He's routing. We'll hopefully be able to get him back. I mean, we've still got quite a few ships in the fight here, so we're not doing terribly. Look at that, he's come back. Let's see how long he comes back for. Put him on round shot. Got our other flutes in the fight now. Just exactly what we wanted. Six rate's not looking too hot. Let's pull him around back. Yeah. Get in there. He has 5 men left, and 2 guns. How is he still going as a threat? Oh no, our sloop surrendered. Ooh, that thing's actually sinking. Oh god. He wasn't having it, apparently. I'm terrible at naval battles. And he surrendered. Thank god. We're done with that. Let's try getting our fleet to board him. Now that we can focus the entire strength of our fleet against his last remaining 5th rate. This guy's actually on fire. He's got no shot here. Let's have that fleet over there do chain shot. Oh, we only lost 1 boat. And I'm afraid it's absolutely sunk. It's gone. Which is probably a lot better than what the AI would have done for us. Probably would have lost like 3 or maybe even lost the battle entirely. So, can't complain too much because it's not too bad. Oh! Piss in a bucket. Wasn't that nice? Look at that. Well, bugger me with a fish fork. Nice, here we come. Coming up to a boarding attack. Try and get him around back here. I'm gonna try and get him. Yeah. And bring you around this way. Yeah. The boats don't position very well. Look at that struggle. And that sloop's coming around. You can cut around this way. And what are we putting you on here? Actually, you can go this way. Go this way. Actually, that's our ship on that side, isn't it? Never mind. Yeah, set you in position there. Drop anchor. And we'll just angle ourselves. And get some nice shots off on him. And bring the rest of our boats round to bear. Let's do that. These full sail if possible. He's just having immense difficulties now at this point. Oh yeah, we're doing real well. That. The pirates have clubs. They're actually using wooden sticks to fight us. Incredible. Yeah, no wonder they're losing. Not many of our people are getting hit by wooden sticks. I'll tell you that. There we go, now he's wavering away. He'll be ours in 2 seconds. Well, not literally, but... There he is. Surrendered. Saucy. And that's the Battle of the East Indies. Close victory. And I think that's fantastic. I mean, look at this. fifth rate, and two Zabeks. The other sank. Fancy. Well, don't we just feel wonderful about ourselves? It's like Gregorian calendar again. And our next fleet has arrived. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and slap him on that trading post. And then with this, we're gonna go back to India. And we're gonna rebuild our boats. Because they're not doing too hot. You know what I mean. That building is still not repaired. What can we do? Infiltrate? Successful. They're not doing anything there. Well, to be expected. Let us get more mix of this. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to try and buy more from Spain. Regions. Flanders. Please do give me money. I wish. Rejected. So we're going to have to go to war with them. Because we do require the territory. Let's go ahead and start building up here so that we can take French Guiana too. With our boats here, we'll attack Guadeloupe and Port of Spain. Basically, by doing that, we're disallowing the pirates the ability to build ships. So they're not going to be able to do too much there. How is our roads are coming up? Okay. Right, so we're going to go ahead and attack Flanders. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and do a bit of a sneak attack on Spain. And what we do here is we declare war on New Spain, which is their protectorate in America. This is their colonies. And by declaring war specifically on them, who's joining? Everyone joins us. Nice. We don't go to war with France and Louisiana and all that nastiness. Because we declared war individually on a Spanish colony, meaning only Spain will protect it. And it looks like Britain and all sorts joined us in the war. So Spain is now at war with... Well, it hasn't popped up yet, but... Spain's at war with pretty much everyone. And we're going to go ahead and take our army and go attack. Try and make them surrender. They don't want to surrender. Not surprised. They get those silly mortars. So we're not going to look forward to that. We're going to go ahead and attack and wipe them out. Take Brussels, and that's one of our victory regions completed. So we'll see you in the war, eh?